flow of genetic information from DNA into proteins forms one of the most critical processes in biology. It provides the foundation for our cell's function, as proteins are synthesized from genetic code via the transcription of DNA into mRNA, and the translation of mRNA into a functioning protein. In nature, there are systems in place to regulate such functions through the regulation of gene expression. Enter one of the most critical discoveries in the field of genetics, a potent way to silence the expression of genes by targeting mRNA transcripts with double-stranded RNA. This is the story of a groundbreaking discovery, opening the doors to greater understanding about gene regulation mechanisms, from the first promising results observed from Caenorhabditis elegans under the microscope to the unveiling of precise mechanisms behind how exogenously introduced double-stranded RNA can induce post-transcriptional gene silencing. This is the story of how RNA interference was discovered. Before the discovery of RNA interference, it was known that endogenous single-stranded RNA can be found in nature as a regulator of gene expression. In 1986, it was discovered that the mRNA transcript encoding for a gene in Drosophila had appeared to have been reduced by the presence of another endogenous RNA transcript. In 1991, researchers discovered that exogenous single-stranded antisense RNA molecules could trigger silencing of complementary mRNA transcripts encoding for muscle proteins and progeny of Caenorhabditis elegans. The results of these experiments raised questions regarding the precise mechanisms behind this inhibitory effect, but it was not until 1998 when a team of researchers led by Andrew Fire and Craig Mello sought to uncover more about these obscure details, leading them to discover RNA interference. Fire and his colleagues were aware of the in vivo effects sense and antisense RNA exhibited on C. elegans, so they broadened their scope, following an ambition to uncover the mechanism pertaining to this interference. Chiefly, they attempted to alleviate the obscurity behind why both sense and antisense RNA seem to inhibit gene expression. They predicted that there may be a structural difference between the interfering RNA and the afflicted mRNA transcript. It was possible that the interfering RNA molecules themselves assumed a double-stranded structure in order to inhibit gene expression. To account for this, their approach consisted of synthesizing a variety of both sense, antisense, and a double-stranded hybrid RNA of both strands, injecting them into the gonads, head, and tail of C. elegans. Each RNA molecule targeted homologous mRNA transcripts responsible for certain observable phenotypic outcomes. Here's what they found. The researchers injected the exogenous RNA into the parental C. elegans gonads to target complementary UNC22 gene transcripts in the embryos. This gene is responsible for encoding myofilament proteins necessary for muscle contraction. They found that the parents injected with the double-stranded hybrid RNA produced progeny who had a strong twitch, a phenotype observed among C. elegans with a loss-of-function mutation in the UNC22 gene. The progeny whose parents were injected with either sense or antisense RNA did not show twitching, indicating no loss of function within the expression of UNC22. In fact, among most of the targeted gene transcripts, neither the sense nor antisense RNA strands would produce any significant interference. These results once again indicated that double-stranded RNA has a regulatory effect on gene expression, yet the precise mechanisms behind this interference was unknown. After observing their results, they speculated a targeting mechanism caused by a catalyst activity. This later turned out to be true. In 2000, a study discovered RNA interference in certain Drosophila cells exhibiting nuclease activity of a specific enzyme operating in tandem with an RNA component. They named the enzyme RNA-induced silencing complex, or RISC. In 2001, researchers discovered that exogenous double-stranded RNA in Drosophila could be broken down by a certain protein termed dicer into fragments roughly 22 nucleotides long. This short interfering RNA assembles with a protein component to form an active RISC enzyme, with the RNA acting as a guide to degrade complementary mRNA. The discovery made by Fire and his team has launched the field of genetics into exciting new areas of research, like in agricultural biotechnology. In 2006, double-stranded RNA hybrids were used to suppress the production of certain allergens in tomato plants, resulting in low allergenic tomato fruits. But perhaps one of the biggest prospects of RNA interference technology lies in the opportunities for therapeutic applications. A groundbreaking study conducted in 2018 showed a successful trial of patisiran, a small interfering RNA agent, treating a hereditary neuropathic condition known as amyloidosis by targeting mRNA encoding for abnormal transthyretin proteins. This profound medical discovery owes its existence to the discovery of RNA interference, to the research done in 1996 by Fire and his team in the progeny of C. elegans.